Hello everyone, good morning to all, welcome to biology class. So we are discussing the chapter cell and we just mentioned about the basic features, that is a number of cells, regarding the number of cells, shape of cells, size of cells, etc. Next we are going to discuss about the parts of cell. Mainly, a cell has three important components. Three major parts are there. They are the cell membrane, cytoplasm, and nucleus. The cell membrane is also known as the plasma membrane. It is the outermost covering of the cell, or it is the boundary of the cell. The cell membrane which can separate a cell from the adjacent cell. And also, it helps in the transport of materials. It helps in the transport of materials between the cell. That means from one cell to another cell, or from outside to inside, and also from inside to outside. And when we are considering the transport of materials across the cell membrane, it is not a complete transporting system, but it is a selectively permeable membrane. Permeability means the capacity of this membrane to allow the movement of materials. So it is not a completely permeable one. It is a partially or selectively permeable one. That means it is not allowing the entry and exit of all kind of materials, but it is selecting some of the important needy materials. What are the needy materials required by the cell? All this is transporting to inside. At the same time, what are the waste materials they are transporting to outside from the cell? To allow this transport, when we are looking at the plasma membrane, we can see that throughout the plasma membrane or cell membrane, small openings or pores are there. This pores can allow the transport of materials through this cell membrane. The second part is the central dense or this round shaped body, that is called the nucleus. When we are comparing the cell with an egg, just compare the cell. Egg is also one cell. Think about the egg. Egg is covered by a hard shell. Like that, our cell is covered by a plasma membrane or cell membrane. Then inside the egg, we can see the white. That is a white colored this protein. This white we can compare to our cytoplasm. And at the center, we can see the yolk, manyakaru. Okay. This yolk we can compare to the nucleus. So three main parts of the cell, they are the cytoplasm, then nucleus and cell membrane. Then in case of any plant cell, we can see one additional covering over this plasma membrane or cell membrane to give extra protection. We know that most of the animals are sheltered. They are living inside the shelter homes or any other kind of shelters are there for most of the animals. But the plants are always staying outside. That is why they have to withstand all kind of climatic changes. So in order to withstand this climate changes, their body has a special kind of protection. Their body cell has a special kind of protection, that is in the form of cell wall. That means the plasma membrane is additionally covered by one more layer, that is called a cell wall. In case of animals, we can see the skeletal system to provide the structural support. So here there is no such kind of these systems to provide structural support. So this cell membrane, cell wall, which can provide shape and rigidity to the plant cell, at the same time it can protect the plant cell from these external forces or external strains such as heavy rain, wind, then strong wind or any other kind of external strains. Just observe the figure 8.6. You can see the human cheek cells. Here we can see the three main parts very clearly. Nucleus, cytoplasm and cell membrane. Everything is there. Then cytoplasm is a jelly-like substance present between the cell membrane and the nucleus. The other components, including the nucleus, they are suspended inside in the cytoplasm. You can see small dots there. When you're observing the figure 8.6, you can see inside the cytoplasm, small black dots are there. Other than the nucleus, we can see these dots. So these dots are indicating the cell organelles such as mitochondria, Golgi bodies, ribosomes, etc. present in our cell. Okay, the detailed study of the cell organelles, that is in higher class, you have to study what is the cell membrane, what are the main functions of the cell membrane, and what is cytoplasm, then detailed study of nucleus. That we will do in the next class. Okay, that's all.